Hi there. In this video I'm going to show you how to replace the paddle lights in an A4 B8 from 2010. First thing, you need a flathead screwdriver, and at this end you put it in there, pry it a bit, and then rotate the flathead, and this thing should start to come out. Now you have two variants. You can either remove this plug, it has a clip here and a clip on the other side. Oh, this is hot, this is really hot. I'm also upgrading mine to LED, this is why I'm doing this, but you can put normal lights if yours are just blown out. But I will be upgrading to LED, this is really hot. Anyway, you can undo this so you are sure you don't make a short in there. You can also wait for your car to time out these bulbs, and it will shut it off by itself if you don't open or close the doors. You leave them like this open. But for me, I will wait for the timeout because I already know this connector is hard to pull out. So we undo this. As you can see, I'm just pulling on the plastic in here, and we can see the bulb, incandescent bulb in there, but it's extremely hot for the moment, and we will wait for it to turn off, and then we'll use a piece of plastic to push it from the end and get it out. If yours it's already blown, it's cold to the touch, so you can obviously push it out. So I'll be back in a second. For me, this is what I will be putting in there. It's a W5W bulb, LED type, but because all the light needs to go only down, so through this thing, I choose one that only has on one side the LED chips themselves and the electronic on the other side, which is exactly what we need in this situation. On the back of it we don't need any light. If you want to see more info on this thing, here it is. Anyway, and I have a full video where I also replace this thing, obviously, which is actually already replaced with LED. But yeah, waiting for the timeout at the moment. Got the old bulb out. As you can see, my lights timed out. It's a W5W, if my camera would actually focus on it. 5 watts bulb, and the LEDs we will be putting in consume even less than half a watt, so they are 10 times more efficient, which is actually great. So at this point I just need to push this thing in there, but cannot do it with one hand, so let's get to it. And make sure this thing is tight enough so it will squeeze enough on this, but the PCB is quite thick, so yeah, make sure it stays in there quite okay. And this thing is in, and I put it back like this just for a second, both of them, so I can close the door so they light up again, so I can show you. And as you can see, no light from the back, obviously no LED chips in there, all the light from the middle, and it's a nice white light, and it's not anything really extremely bright. Yeah, it's exactly as it should be. At this point, throw the cover back on. Make sure you don't short circuit anything. It has two pins, one here, one here. Those need to go there in the bottom, something like that. And then clipped in place, and there's that. Put this thing into its hole, and we are done. And let me just show you the color difference from the other door that I'm also doing. Ooh. And this one is already off, so let me first turn it on in a moment. Come on. Yep, that's yellow, and then that's white. You can see a tenth of the power draw about the same amount of light, because I didn't want anything extremely bright, like a UFO taking off, but much whiter and better looking. So yeah, there's that. Okay, and this is done. It will look much better at night compared to what it was. And yeah, if this video helps you, please give it a like, check out my other A4B8 related videos, and as always, see you in the next one. And I do recommend you switch to LEDs also. Dedicated video for all of the interior lights in the link in the description of this video. So yeah, bye.